and a very good morning to you on this Wednesday, the 24th of August. Happy Hump Day, Carl.
It's
hard not to jig to that one, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it's a good jigging song.
Yeah, yeah.
You know.
That's true.
Yeah, do you know who's not jigging? There's a jigger who's missing.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, he's fully erupted, has he?
Lisa didn't even notice.
It was. It's a big
void.
You
know, sometimes there's other stuff going on in the morning and, you know, you just...
Big presence to miss.
Yeah, someone's
find
missing.
Find it very hard not to notice Timmy's absence.
Is it Timmy? And I've got a question for you, Sylvia.
Yes.
Have you ever been to Bob's Knob?
Not that I can recall.
Deb?
Not recently, no.
No? You've been to Fanny Bay?
Oh, maybe once. But it was a long time ago. Prince Harry has left the safety of Kensington Palace for the African wilderness to wrestle a crocodile. Well, you might recall Peter Stefanovic wrestling a few crocs not too long ago as well.
Just getting ready for marriage?
No. You calling me a beast?
I think you just did.
I assure you I'm easier to pin down than a crocodile, Tim.
So
well, I mean, you know...
What's happened to this show?
That's mean.
Well, why don't you, to prepare Carl and the kids for us, tell us what it's like the first time you have one of those incredibly angry beasts beneath you.
it's like any animal. You have to take it easy. Just not.
I thought Lisa would come back with a clean
underneath.
Head.
Yeah.
He's got an extra string in his
I want to know, what generally is it like when you jump on board?
No, you
go on.
You got to...
ask a serious question.
Yeah, totally, totally. No, just understand the animal before you go jumping on it.
Should I have a go?
Yeah, you go.
Hey, Thor! Hello! Good work! I'm sure he appreciates my thumbs up. I'm sure that'll get him fired up for his day of filming. Oh, I said a good 15 metres. It had to be the scream. I apologise to everyone's ears who would have heard that straight down the microphone.
Every bloke's heard that before.
Make the bed, James.
Pick up your towel.
She's a screamer.
Okay, Alan.
Lisa.
He's such a nice guy.
Not a proper bloke. Yes. Every proper bloke I know would love to be called a hunk.
Well, that's because they're not a hunk like Chris Hemsworth, so I suppose.
I don't think he's that precious, surely. Timmy Gilbert, you're
a
hunk.
He's not precious. He just gets
come at me. Any of those words, love
yes.
it.
Yes.
Hunk. I usually get chunk, but I don't mind hunk.
You're a chunk of hunk.
Chunk of hunk of burning love.
That's right. It's what Josie always tells us.
But right now, it is time now for a hunk of sporting love.
AFL and Dame Swan.
What was that?
I don't know.
Indigestion.
Wasn't good. Just the ball.
Hey,
very,
out the way.
Fast grim, 14 on the stent meter. Doesn't help when there's someone in front. Oh, the puck went in. Patrick Reed currently leads the field on 11 under.
Oh, come on.
Oh. Oh, Dickie. Mid spray.
Sorry.
That's big. If Dickie refuses to spray because he's so excited, that's big.
Excitement levels.
Wow.
Oh, dear.
Every time I mention Tahiti, reminds me of that soap ad all those years ago. Tahiti looks nice.
Oh, what
remember
was
they
that?
Just clipped in the soap? Was it the Camé or the...
No, it wasn't Camé. I think it was Cousins Imperial Leather.
That's the one.
Oh, and they were there was a big spa bath in the plane.
Yeah.
And they were trying to work out where they were going to go.
James, Tahiti looks nice.
What a beautiful soap the Imperial Leather was. Yeah. All my rich friends had that Imperial Leather.
There you go.
Yeah, and it had a little magnet on it, so it stuck up on the bath.
On special at Woolies at the moment, apparently.
I used to go to my mate's house and just have baths.
Didn't think you were dodgy at all.
Oh. Spent a lot of time in the bar.
Big thanks to everyone, the cast of Aladdin! If you want to come and see the show at the Capitol Theatre, all the details will be on our website. Carl and Lisa, we'll finish off with a nice little Arabian Orchi bottle, Carlos. Cheers.
Oh, that's funny. I'm hearing you, buddy.
How long have you guys been lining up for the iPhone?
Since Wednesday morning we've been lining up, so it's been quite a long time.
Okay, now... Of course, these phones are an expensive item. Have you boys got some money to buy these? You got? Oh, hang on a second. Oh, look at this.
Okay.
We definitely have some money ready for the... Apparently, these boys, just 48 hours ago, were on the Gold Coast with Jared Hayne, and that's where they managed to get the cash on. That's pretty good. You guys have been in the line for 3 days, lining up for the new iPhone 7. How long did you line up for that hat?
It was a difference to me in line.
Yeah, I didn't expect that you lined up for that. There is probably a line backed up around the corner now of maybe 100, which means that if these guys at the front who have been waiting for 3 days were just to arrive now, they would have to wait 10 minutes to get the new iPhone. It's a countdown. You'd swear that this was... Oh, my God!
There we go. It's all happening, Merrick.
It's bigger than NASA. It really is. You would swear. Look at that guy there. Go, Prissy. Go. You get in there, son.
Get in there, son.
How's your Aussie accent?
Oh, awful. It's so
really?
Bad.
Oh, you've got to
give
it.
Give us some.
Yeah. Oh, it's so bad. It really is.
Are you with that?
Traveller, right? Traveller is a... beer you travel with, right?
Yeah.
You're not supposed to say that?
That's a roadie.
A roadie. What's a traveller? Something completely
different. You just admitted
have
it.
I just alienated everybody in the country?
You haven't alienated anyone.
All the blokes are watching.
I think a few women are as well. You're half Australian already.
Hey, can I just say, I'm very excited to be on this show. I've been a big fan of your show for a long time, and I was just over in LA, and you know, one of the members of your team has mythical status over there.
Yeah.
I was in a car getting lift from a driver, and he asked me why I was there, and I said TV, and he said, "Oh, the Nine Network." He said, "I've just given Lisa a lift," and then he said a sentence which I was not expecting. He said, "And the one they call the Dick." And I said, "Oh, Richard." I said, "We love Richard," and he said, "You love the Dick." And I said, "That's not the words I would have used, but yes."
Are you afraid of the toilet ever? This is important because the survey has been done. One third of Aussies suffer from toilet anxiety. This includes public and home toilets. But what about this one? You're maybe in the toilet and a bloke next to you gives it this one. What do you think about that? Know what I'm saying, fellas? Know what I'm saying?
I don't think I've ever seen that.
It's a bit disconcerting. Over to you, Lisa.
Yeah, Joker's at Campbelltown City Council issued his Batmobile a parking fine as he was showcasing it to school children.
Obviously, you've had a lot of problems with people around Gotham City. You're like the Riddler, the Joker, the Iceman, all issues for you. Do you think one of them's behind it?
Penguin?
Yeah, it could be a large conspiracy here. Yeah, I think if I lost my licence, then I couldn't fight crime, so I think that would be a pretty smart way of tackling the Batman problem.
I've gotten inside the mind of Blocky. And so we figured we'd try to read the weather in here and give Blocky a chance at just changing job roles this morning. So this is what's going on with the weather right around the country today. We've got some showers for Cairns, but it's fun. Well, very hard to see in here as well, let me tell you. Or even move.
Oh, there'll be no money left when you break the plasma.
Woohoo! Whoa. Gee. For all you kids out there, Blocky is real.
His legs only just make it at the bottom.
I saw someone do this with a vacuum cleaner, and it was a ponytail. But I had to go beyond ponytail because my daughter's a ballerina.
Yeah.
So you're a tall 8-year-old.
Yeah.
Well, you're a ballerina.
The thing is, I had to get a stand in just today, okay? Because you know, kids are at school, aren't they? Almost.
What does mum look like?
Here we go. Now I'm just going to pull the hair back at the top.
I'm a little bit afraid.
Because you want the ballet bun to look nice. Gee, it's nice.
How are you feeling, Jem?
Good.
Suck that in there. Look at this.
This is working well.
All right, look at this. This is happening.
Tonight on A Current Affair. 11-year-old loser's
hair. You can see it, right? So then you just enjoy your
parenting
and it sucks in there.
Great.
Feels fantastic. It's looking pretty good from the front, I got to say.
Yeah.
Look at her face.
She's flinching a little bit.
I'll just take it off, like that.
And the ponytail's in.
And the head's off the head's shoulders.
That's right. Wow. Okay, you just pull that thing a little bit tight like that.
Excellent. How are you going, Jim?
Yeah, good. I'm actually not sure that a brush couldn't have achieved that.
Yeah.
Just before we go, we might go out for a game of golf and I might make a play for the caddy, but if I do, I won't follow through because my heart belongs to Daddy.